And now, would you welcome to the cage his opponent from Lunas Magnus, right here in Doncaster? He is the Hurricane, Marcin Prostko! Introducing to you firstly in the blue corner, wearing camouflage shorts, he weighed in at 93 kilograms. From Lockdown MMA in Lincoln, Ian Porter! And his opponent across the cage in the red corner, wearing black shorts, he too weighed in at 93 kilograms. From Lunas Magnus, right here in Doncaster, he is the Hurricane, Marcin Prostko! Your referee when the action gets underway is Craig Lawrence. This is three 3-minute rounds of MMA.
Yes, this is amateur MMA, three 3-minute rounds. And Jay, it's also a rematch. These two men fought to a decision last time out, with Marcin Prostko getting that decision. I spoke to Ian Potter earlier today and he said, well, one of the ways you make sure of the win is a stoppage.
Yeah, if I remember the first fight correctly, you know, it was close, tit for tat. The Hurricane, as they called Prostko, it came out fast and hurt Potter early, but as he sort of, as he slowed down a little bit, Potter really came into the fight quite strongly later in the round, so he'll probably feel buoyed by the fact that he did have some success towards the end of their first fight. So, no doubt it was him calling for the rematch.
Yes, and both men said that they'd learned from fighting each other before and they knew what they had to do this time out. And a good strong low kick from Prostko there.
Yeah, Prostko's a big physical unit. And we've seen him, well, I saw him debut here at CSFC. And then I think he's fought most of his fights here since. I've been keen to see his progression. He sort of gassed out early in his first fight and got hurt, but he's been getting better and better and obviously working more on his fitness and his all-round MMA game.
Well, I'm just about to say, at the moment, in this opening round, it's almost like a K-1 bout.
Yeah, and every time you open your mouth to speak and say something like that, then they do the opposite. That tends to happen. Yeah, I think Prostko just... He took a nice left up there from Potter and it seemed to have woke him up a bit. He gave Potter the stare down.
And again, works to the left leg of Potter. Potter tries the right hand response and at the moment it's been all upright. As I said, very much like a K-1 bout.
Yeah, and Prostko is really teeing up those low kicks. He's telegraphing them, but it doesn't seem Potter has the will or the want to check them, even though they're coming in from way downtown.
Yeah, you do need to check them. They're landing, they're strong, and it will affect him later in terms of his mobility. And another one lands there. Now, the right-hand counter is the right move, but it's got to land.
Yeah, it didn't come too far away that time, but then they sort of engage with some more hands. But if you can find them out with that right hand, once Prostko sort of comes in with that low kick, I just say it's the right one to work, but I'd like to see him follow it up, you know, maybe with a cross-up, cross combination, you know, in case the first one misses.
And again, on Prosco's behalf, if you're getting countered with that rear leg, use the lead leg to the inside of your opponent's lead leg. It's closer and it puts you at less risk from that right-hand counter that Potter's looking to tee up.
Yeah, but he's had success so far. So, you know, his game plan will stay the same until he gets tagged. Oh, nice back kick there. And it's
hurt Potter. Felt it, you're right, Jay. Potter felt it. Prosco, an immediate response. It was a delayed reaction, wasn't it?
And Prosco's swarming. I think Potter might be out of this one. He sees out the end of the round. I'm not sure if it was a tap there or...
Was he waving at the ref almost like a tap to say, is it over? Does Prosco think it's over?
Prosco seems to think it is over. The referee disagrees, but Potter is still hurt. I don't think he wants to carry on.
How did you see that, Jay? I saw that almost like Potter was trying to get the referee's attention to say a verbal tap out.
It appeared so, but, you know, the referee was very close to the action there. And if he would have said, you know, I want out, I'm sure the referee would have called it. It's hard to tell. I mean, you know, sticking your arm out there, either tap or, you know, make it more obvious if you're not in a good spot.
That's right. Controversial moment. But what wasn't controversial is from that kick, Prosco took full advantage, didn't he?
Yeah, he definitely did. He swarmed in there. Potter tried to look for the takedown to buy himself some time. I think we're going to see a second round. Yeah, so, you know, he did the right thing to buy himself some time, but Prosco was just too strong, especially when you're in a weakened state, when you've been winded like that. It was a nice move from Prosco. He missed the low kick and spun for that spinning back kick there, and it landed. And as you often see with the body shots, delayed reaction.
So what has Ian Potter got left in the tank? Because the end of that round was relentless from Marcin Prosco, and you know he's going to look for more of the same here in the second, knowing that his man has been at his mercy like that. Let's see what Potter's got to recover with.
He looks for that same shot again.
Just out of range this time.
Yeah, I think you're going to see Potter a lot more tentative this round, because, you know, when you've been hurt like that, it does play on your mind.
And again, that rear leg lands to the lead leg of Potter, which will slow his mobility even more.
Prosco definitely a fan of that one now.
Yeah, sometimes you can reach overkill and he needs to set it up differently or wait and maybe do it again in the third round rather than consistently doing it. Short left hand from Potter doesn't really find the mark.
He's not having too much success in these stand-up exchanges. Maybe a change of tack for Potter might be a good idea.
Yes, Marcin very strong in these exchanges. Again, the left hand just gets through from the double jab. And again, targets the lead leg of Potter here in the second round. But the longer this goes on like this, the one thing for Potter, it does clear his head, doesn't it?
Yeah, he'll be recovering every second that is in the cage. His head will be getting a little bit more clear.
Look for the bolo punch, the overhand right with his own head down, did Potter. Didn't land. That lead leg showing damage of Potter's now to the rear, targeted by the right leg of his opponent, Prosco.
Yeah, Prosco is a big physical guy, and when he's digging that shin in so many times over the course of these first two rounds, you know, it is really going to take its toll. Oh, nice right hand there lands from Prosco, and you just saw his eyes widen.
Yeah, they both threw leather, but as you said, Jay, it was the right hand of Prosco that was the exclamation mark of that exchange. And picking up what you said earlier, it's a dangerous game that Potter's playing by staying on his feet after seeing this power. He hasn't tried to change tack, has he?
He seems comfortable on his feet. As I recall, that is his primary fighting style, so it's what's comfortable to him. But these guys are mixed martial artists, so I'm sure he's got takedowns and ground game. Oh, there's the cut on the head of Prosco there.
It looks on the side of his head, yeah. The blood's running down by the ear. It's certainly not going to be in a dangerous position in terms of his sight or impairing his vision.
Sometimes the sight of your opponent's blood can spur you on a little bit. I'm not quite sure what caused it.
Well, the thing that interests me here is and again that right hand, then the left this time, and Potter suddenly comes back. What a way to end the round, and they have to be pulled apart.
Last 10 seconds, the clapper went, and they went like the clappers. That was a furious exchange at the end of that round.
And I was just about to say, Jay, that the one thing about the exchanges is there's been very little in real range. They haven't taken that step in to really make it count. And just as I was about to say that, that last 10 seconds was all about range, taking that extra step in and really planting the feet and throwing the leather.
Yeah, and both guys had the chins wide up in the air. I was expecting someone to fall over. When you've got guys at this weight, planting the feet, as you say, and throwing the leather like that, when the chins up in the air, I was expecting someone to be felled like a tree. But, both guys, to their credit, shipped a few of those shots, and it potentially sets up for an exciting third round.
So third and final round, and both men are still on their feet after that dramatic exchange at the end of the second. And all it needs to be seen now is whether they will continue that in the third, taking those risks, Jay, stepping forward and letting the leather throw.
It's what the crowd would love to see. It all depends, when you felt the power of your opponent in those kind of exchanges, does it give you more confidence, or, did you get tagged and did it hurt? And, that'll decide what happens next. Whether Potter feels he can really step in and take Prosco's shots to land his own.
Yeah. Potter throwing a couple of tentative jabs, but nothing like we saw at the end of that round yet. This time he moves away from the right leg attempt from Prosco.
Yeah, I'd like to see... careful how I word this. I'd like to see underneath them shorts of Potter to see what's going on with that lead leg, because he has taken a lot of shots, but Prosco is not really turning the hip over and driving it in with full force.
And he checked for the first time as well, Jay, so they might be having the... But the other thing Prosco doesn't do is often, even if it's not having the damage effect, the balance effect, he hasn't really capitalised on follow-up. They've been single shots and he's moved back out of range again. And often when you can take your man off balance, especially if he suddenly switched to the inside of the leg, again here he doesn't follow it up.
Yeah, he seems content to land that one shot, score the points and then move back out again.
Don't get me wrong, it is a safe tactic and it does rack up points, but you just feel with an added sense of urgency or a bit more determination, one of these men could force the stoppage that was talked about prior to the fight.
Yeah, definitely. He looks almost on the way to go in the way of the first fight, which I don't think either guy will be particularly happy with. Obviously, Prosco will be happy with a win, but, he wanted to put an exclamation mark on it. And for me, he hasn't been aggressive enough to do that just yet.
And again, by the same token, Ian Potter, tentative when he comes forward to throw those jabs. And when he throws the right hand on the end of them, he's just not close enough. It's not going to land with the power that he needs at this late stage of the fight.
Like to see Prosco in the second round, he worked that low kick behind that jab so he could really step in and set up the heavier kick, but he's just been throwing singles again in round three. Maybe it's a gas tank thing, or maybe he's just happy with the results. It's hard to tell.
Well, it's been upright for virtually all the three rounds. It's been like a K1 bout rather than an MMA bout. And again, that leg, as you said, I don't know about the damage, but it's been targeted, it's been scored. And again, they hear the last 10 seconds, and suddenly Potter closes the gap. I think it's going to be too little, too late for him, and I think this will go the way of the first one.
Yeah, Potter, he got really hurt in the first round. He seemed to find his rhythm at the end of the second round a little bit, but he's just let Prosco dictate the pace.
Could you please show
dictated the range of the fight. And he's just tried to do too much at the end there, and he's not left himself with enough time, not enough urgency.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three thrilling rounds of MMA action, we go to our judges' scorecards. We have a unanimous decision with all three scoring judges scoring the contest in favor of your winner. From Lunas Magnus.